This is an exciting time within the organization. Over the next few months, we'll be rolling out Access. We're delivering beds for kids. In the very near future, care packages for all our families to combat COVID. Also, Wi-Fi, free Wi-Fi access for all of our families. And also, community garden. All of these pillars represent economic opportunities, education, and health and wellness. One of our maintenance men was doing an inspection and discovered the child didn't have a bed. He was sleeping on a makeshift pallet. And so I said, if this exists in one unit, it most likely exists in other units. We said, okay, let's create an initiative. That initiative was Beds for Kids. We reached out to our philanthropic community members, the Baton Rouge Area Foundation, as well as other civic and business people throughout the community contributed to the initiative, raising over $20,000 for our families. We have a great team at the Housing Authority. They were able to coordinate the delivery, the ordering, and installation of the beds. Town and Country was one of our great partners. They actually allowed us to purchase the bed at cost for our families, and they actually delivered them as well.
It was truly a blessing. It felt wonderful, especially in the economic hardship that a lot of us are experiencing right now. It truly felt great.
The Housing Authority continues to fulfill its mission for serving our families. Today, we distributed care packages to not only the families of Charlotte Terrace, but all the other housing communities that we serve in the East Baton Rouge Parish. We included in our care packages no-touch thermometers, disposable mask, reusable mask, hand sanitizer, hand soap, mental health care advice, as well as financial literacy. These are all things that are necessary to help our families navigate this pandemic and the crisis that we're in today.
East Baton Rouge Housing Authority is truly amazing because when these type of programs are formulated and put together, it's presented to them and they turn it over to them to make it work.
Our families need it because we serve the frontline workers, the disabled individuals, as well as our elderly residents. And so these are the people that are most vulnerable to the COVID pandemic.